Okay, welcome back. This is exercise number two in Hanon's The Virtuoso Pianist. Once again, I'm going to demonstrate in this area of the piano first. Now, there's a couple things that we need to talk about before we do the exercise number two, and those are the differences between this exercise and the one that you learned previously, exercise number one. Okay. The first major difference is the fingering. In number one, when you played your four in your left hand, you played your two in your right hand. Remember? Okay? That's not the case anymore. Now, with this one, and it's just something you have to accept, okay? Now, when you play your two in your right hand, you play your three in your left hand. Okay, so we have two and three together. All right, so for instance, okay. Now the other thing is there's a lot more spacing between the notes. This isn't a stepwise exercise like number one is, all right? So to get used to playing, what I want you to do first is only playing the first three notes of every measure, right? Let me say that again. Only play the first three notes of every measure in both the ascending and the descending, all right? This is what tends to throw students. They try to take too much and they get confused because they keep thinking about number one. So this is what I want you to do. Go to the piano and play. Right? And that's C, E, A. With 5-3-1 in the left hand and 1-2-5 in the right hand. All right? Now, if you're going to play the whole first page, it would look like this. You see how you're playing the same fingers every time. All you're doing is you're moving the whole hand up one note. Keep going. We got two more. And remember, we reached that B, and that's where the transition point is. Now, here's the cool thing. The notes are exactly the same going up as they are going down. So we just played. Now, remember, we're only playing the first three notes. So we play. Remember, we don't care about anything else in the measure, only the first three notes and the fingering of the first three notes. And this one ends on A. Okay. Now, get used to doing that. I would say if you can't do that comfortably, pause the video, come back to it later once you are comfortable with that. If you are comfortable doing that, then we can add in the whole exercise. There's a pivot point in this exercise. Let me play the whole thing now, the whole first measure anyway. Right? And just like before, it's a pattern that we repeat over and over again, okay? So this time I'm going to go on. Okay? Now, remember what we talked about before, being the big trouble spots tend to be the transition and the ending, okay? So let me show you the transition. Remember, the transition are on these Bs right here, okay? And we have... Okay. And let's talk about the descending just for a moment. Remember that when you hit your 2 in your right hand, you hit your 3 in your left hand. So we have G, D, B, okay? And that is 5-2-1 in our right hand and 1-3-5 in the left hand. It looks like this. Okay, now you may need to do hands separately, especially in the left hand, because it does take some getting used to. So, watch that descending one more time. Okay, now let's look at the ending. Unlike the first one, which ends on G, this one ends on these A's, all right? And we have... Okay, so we go from the F straight down to the C's, all right? Okay, watch that one more time. And that is Hanon, the Virtuoso Pianist, in 60 Exercises, exercise number 2. Have a great day. We'll see you next time.